Get ready to match the stars. Foster Brooks. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Orna Patterson. Dick Martin. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rayburn.
Hey, John. What'd you do to him? Yeah, you're a wonderful bunch, and so are you. Thank you for joining us. Come over here and look at these beautiful stars. Nice to see all of you beautiful stars. Everything okay up there, Chuck?
How about Dick
yes.
and me? It's
what?
Fine, how about Dick and me? You said, how nice to see all you beautiful stars.
Yeah. Well, well, now, Foster, here's the way it is. Well, we get a new kid on the block. We have to give a special welcome.
Gene's eyes have gone. So,
I guess in your case, a simple handshake and a welcome would
thank
be fine.
Glad to have you with us, buddy.
However, in your case,
however,
I broke it.
No, you broke your thing.
We welcome you. Listen, the stagehand backstage, he says, that girl, she's really got a beautiful face.
I paid him to say that.
Oh, I said, didn't you notice the rest of it? He said, no, I didn't. I just saw her face. But anyway, welcome.
Oh, my dear. Yay. Now, here's Christy Cannell and Steve Kinnick.
Now, Christy, how much money have you got?
350.
Okay, and where are we here? Oh, we're going to start with round one. We've just met you at the last minute.
That's right.
You want to refresh our memories and tell
sure.
us where you're from, Steve?
I graduated from University of Oklahoma in 77 and moved out here and have done some substitute teaching, a little bit of modeling. That's it.
Okay, good luck to both of you. Here we go. Steve, you may have A or a B.
I'll have A.
A it is. Here we go. Robbie the Robot said, my wife must be having an affair with another robot. I came home and found blank all over the place. There you are, sir.
Gene,
yeah.
I haven't been on the show in a couple of weeks.
Oh, you haven't? Oh, no. I broke my thing, but anyway.
Savage.
Oh, no. Robbie the Robot said, my wife must be having an affair with another robot. I came home and found blank all over the place.
Found rust.
Rust. Rust. That's a very interesting answer. It's not going to catch anything, but it's an interesting answer.
That's lying.
That indicates parts were utilized which hadn't been utilized recently. Hello there.
Hello.
Are you ready? This is your first shot at it now.
Yeah.
And now that answer, I must say in all candor, without hurting your feelings, Steve, was not a
Steve.
Great answer.
I'll lay it 2
As
to 1.
In fact, it was rotten.
Lay it 2 to 1. Nobody has that.
I won't take that bet.
I was thinking of plugs.
Plugs, yes.
You know. Plug yeah. it in and
right.
light it up.
Okay. All right. Yeah. That's good. You're off to a good
oh,
start.
It's not good at all. You're just being
wait, no,
kind.
Wait a minute. He's at his first
end.
Time. He's a guest, and I got to say, it's good to encourage him. He'll walk out.
No,
then
you've
we?
Got yeah. to get him nervous so he'll try and perk up a little bit. Batteries.
Batteries all over the place.
That's I didn't say I had a good answer. I said his was rotten, too.
So far, we haven't had a really good answer, Charles. I hope
no,
you'll come up
one
with
there.
One.
How have you been, all right?
All
I
right.
said screws, nuts, and bolts.
Now, there's a good answer.
See?
No,
that's not a good
screws,
answer.
Screws, nuts, and bolts. Yeah. Okay, now, this is your first shot at it. What do you say to this? Robbie the Robot said my wife was having an affair with another robot. I came home, found blank all over the place.
Oil.
Oil.
So I'm afraid she's with me.
Oil. She is with you.
She is with me.
You're getting the idea now, right, Steve?
Got it.
Okay. Now, Miss Betty, a little rust for Steve.
Remember, I haven't been on the show in a couple of weeks.
Oh, yes.
Shoes.
Shoes.
Oh, shoes?
No,
what did
tubes.
She say?
She said tubes.
Oh, I thought she said shoes. I've always spoken very well of you.
So, we'll have a first round question for you, but right now, dear friend, we have this for you. Here we go now with Christy's first round question. This one says, Rita said, my son just told me he wants to marry the girl down the street. What's upsetting is, down the street, there's a blank.
Down the street, there's a who?
Down the street, there's a blank.
Oh, down the street, there's
That's
a blank.
What's upsetting her.
Wait a minute.
Rita said, my son just told me he wants to marry the girl down the street. What's upsetting is, down the street, there's a blank.
House of ill repute.
A house of ill repute.
Okay.
She said, a house of ill repute, Foster.
How do you spell that?
H-O-U-S-E.
O-A-R.
No, I came up with that one.
House of ill repute. Yeah.
That's spelled correctly.
Yeah. Perfect. Spelling doesn't count. It was figured out somehow. Yes, indeed. Yes, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am, what? Sure, it's easy for you to say. I said a rug-making establishment or a hooker joint.
Uh-huh. Okay. You're still writing?
No, this is a match. It has to be a match. I mean, and there's a lot of names for these things, but I think this is a match. House of ill repute.
Yes, of course.
But no cigar.
I think this is a match.
Want to marry the girl down the street? What's upsetting is...
There's a massage parlor down the street.
Uh-uh.
Oh!
No? No, because you see, if we allow that, then we would get a letter from every legitimate massage parlor in the world saying,
That's right.
Hey, all you guys.
No, I don't think... what is the question? Because it doesn't...
Rita said, my son just told me he wants to marry the girl down the street.
Right.
Now, what's upsetting is, down the street, there's a...
A grade school.
A... I love you. All right.
I just am being a good hostess and trying to make our new guest feel at home. I also said massage parlor.
All right, good. So there are two of those and one from Mr. Nabokov there.
It's a terrible neighborhood.
So where are we? 3-0 at the end of the round. One favor, Christy. Now, Steve, you got to go to work and do a little catching up here and forge ahead if you can.
I'll try A again.
A again. All right. A says,
we're in A again.
The 80-year-old stripper said,
I look just like Betty White.
She didn't say that. All right, give her a 6 and let's get on with it. She said, the 80-year-old stripper said, I'd be out of show business if it wasn't for good old Dr. Quackenbush. He made me some orthopedic blanks. Steve Kinnett. The 80-year-old stripper said, he's blushing. I haven't said anything yet, and there it is. She says, how old are you, son? She says, I'd be out of show business if it wasn't for good old Dr. Quackenbush. He made me some orthopedic blanks.
Pasties.
Pasties? What are pasties? I know what you mean here.
Well, just go on.
Oh, all right. Orthopedic pasties, eh? Foster?
Yes.
He wouldn't tell me what pasties were.
Well.
You ain't either, eh?
I won't tell you, but I know what they are.
Oh, all right.
Well, then, if you know, go ahead and tell.
He made me some orthopedic blanks.
There's those little things that you hang with a tassel on them. One goes that way, one goes...
Oh,
that.
I see.
That's okay. In that house of real repute I was telling you about.
Oh, I see.
Let's see. Oh, I had a better answer, but Brett said I couldn't say that.
Oh.
So I said she had artificial boobs. He made artificial boobs.
Orthopedic boobs.
What did he say? What? Oh, pasties.
He said pasties. I think that's the definitive answer. I don't know why you're all in there. Brett has a definitive answer?
Well, she has a right one, but I mean, what's definitive? I would never write one of those because I don't know what definitive means.
I can't even say it. How do I know what it means? What do you got there?
Foster's cute, isn't he?
Yes, he's darling.
We're awful glad to have him with us, aren't we? I was in his dressing room just before we came down here.
Something
that he told me was coughing. You suppose he was lying to me? Boobs.
All right. Maybe we have two of those, or four, depending on how you look at it.
Six.
Six already. Okay. Okay, have three pairs so far there, Lorna.
I just have two.
He made me, the good old Dr. Quackenbush kept me busy. He made me some orthopedic.
You ready, Steve?
And achieve a tie, you've got to match Dick and Betty.
We've got eight boobs.
Eight so far, that means Christy wins the game. What'd you have, Betty? Yes. Well, Steve, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Well, thank you.
Good luck to you, sir. We're going to send some gifts your way for match game 79. Okay. Steve Kinnock.
Bye-bye, ladies and gentlemen.
We'll spin them off. We'll spin them back for two for a minute. Okay, thank you all. Here we are with Christy Cantle again. She got another go at the real big money. You ready for this?
I sure am.
Okay, I hope you're in tune here with all of those stars. We polled a studio audience, Christy, not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. It's only blank. If you match the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, $250. Then for matching the third, $100. Three of our six stars will offer some assistance.
Charles.
It's only a paper moon.
Beautiful song.
Brett.
It's only make-believe.
Betty.
It's only money.
Yeah! It's only money. It's only money, it's only a paper moon, and it's only make-believe. Those are the three they gave you. You have the option now of choosing one of those or giving us one of your own.
Let's try. It's only money. I'll go with the audience.
Okay. All right. She's letting the audience influence her. We'll see how good you are at this. We'll go down there at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. It's only a paper moon. There's the answer that Charles gave you.
Your request, Brett.
Okay, let's look at the next one and see the $250 number. It's only make-believe. Well, you got two out of the three they've given you so far. I think it's a good omen for you, Christy. Good luck as we slide the big one. Very good. All right. Now, you've got a big leap forward here. You got $950. But the most important thing is you're going to play for 10 times the amount you just won, or $5,000. But you get a lucky spin of the star wheel here, you'll double that and play for $10,000. Good luck. Let's all root for a double. Here we go. $5,000 with Dick Martin. And good luck to you. And let's see what we've got on this card for you. All right. Here it is. In your blank.
Oh, yeah.
In your blank. Okay. Now, he's written his answer. If you give us the answer that he has on the card, you get $5,000 in your...
In your life. I can't think of anything.
In your life.
Okay, she said, in your life, we'll match you for the $5,000. Dick, what do you say to that?
I say $950 is good money for her.
That's right.
Yes. Yeah. I said, in your hat.
In your hat. And you've heard that expression, haven't you? You never heard that expression?
Never.
In your
you would have liked my other one, then.
Yes. In your hat. All right, Christy, you're now going to meet your new player. Here comes Vic Zlato. Nice to have you back.
Good to be
back. In case his face looks familiar to you, he was on once before, and there was a little something goofy that went on, and to make everything was okay, but just to make be perfectly fair to Vic, we said, why don't you come back and have a little shot at it? Here we go. And I want to ask you, Tom, in case you forgot where you're from and all that sort of stuff.
They probably did forget. I'm from a little town in Michigan, Cross Village, and it's quite small because in the last election, the supervisor won by one vote, 33-32.
Uh-huh. Boy, that is a small...
And everybody turned out.
Oh, 100%. That's good that they take their voting franchise so seriously. All right, good luck to both players. Here we go. Vic, you can have A or B.
I tossed a coin back there, so I'll have to take A.
No, you take anyone you want.
No, it came up heads for A, so I'm going to take A.
Really? All right. Anything you say. Hey, did you hear about the world's thinnest book?
No!
No! Tell you about the world's thinnest book. It's called Blank's Best Jokes.
What is it?
Blank's Best Jokes is the title of the book.
Look at that.
Look at that.
That's Alan Ludden.
That's not Alan Ludden.
Alan hasn't breathed fire in months.
That thing is really breathing fire. Little sparks coming out of its mouth. That's darling. Okay, Vic. Here we go. Did you hear about the world's thinnest book? I'll tell you, it's called Blank's Best Jokes.
Richard Nixon's.
Yeah.
Richard Nixon's Best Jokes. The implication is he's singularly lacking in humor. What do you say to that, Foster?
Well, I don't talk about that.
Oh, you don't talk about it?
No.
Well, what are you talking about?
You promised me you won't let somebody know I put this name down if I show it to you.
Okay. Charles M. Riley. Don't get angry. No. Now you see, I must explain something to you. We find Charles is a most amusing fellow.
Ha!
On this program, did you ever see him in Vegas?
Oh, all right. Okay, I got you. All right, Brett. Can we get
Howard
out of that?
Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell.
I don't know why I said this. It just seems right. Kate Smith.
Kate Smith. Best jokes. Well, we got some interesting answers so far here, Vic. World's thinnest book. It's called Blank's Best Jokes, and he said Richard Nixon. What do you say?
Do you promise you won't let someone see if I...
Oh, yeah, it'll be our little secret here. Just a...
Brett's Best Jokes.
Ah!
That's it. Fair enough. You will say what you said about Charles.
You won't believe this, but I did have Nixon, and then I recalled that he did our show... And
oh,
said, shock it to me.
Yes,
so
he did.
He did have a sense of humor.
He does,
so
yes.
So I found someone with less sense of humor, Gregory Peck.
Gregory Peck. What do you mean by that?
Yeah.
Cliff Eastwood
somebody did the other day, Gregory Peck sneezing. Ah, choo.
Good. Okay, Miss Betty.
Again, I'm just being a good hostess and making a clean Brett's of it. Brett's best.
Brett's. A lot of Brett's in there. So there we are in the middle of round one. Christy, we've got a question for you, but right now we have this for you. Never heard of In Your Head, eh? Now I ask you, did you hear about the world's smallest town? Here it is. Instead of a cannon, they have a blank in the town square. That should have been your question, eh, Vic? Put it in the slot.
Oh, shit.
Away we go with Christy. Did you hear about the world's smallest town, Christy? Instead of a cannon, they have a blank in the town square.
You know, one of those little pistols?
A little pistol.
You know, 45 or whatever they're called.
Yes, a 38 or a 45. Okay, Foster.
Firecracker.
Firecracker is good. Correct?
I said a water pistol they could drink out of it and...
That's another good one. And Charles?
I said a pop gun.
Pop gun is a very good one. Don't have a straight old pistol yet, do we, Lorna?
No, but we... Do you want to read it? Or
no,
do
you go ahead.
Oh, okay. A cap gun.
Cap gun. That's not a regular pistol. Instead of a cannon, they have
a cap pistol, too.
Cap pistol, yeah. She said a 45 or a 38. What do you say?
Two of the nicest girls in town.
No, I said a slingshot.
A slingshot. So, okay, that's the end of round one and no score. And now we've got this for you. Join us next time for Match Game 79. I'm Gene Rayburn. Thank you all. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 79, a Mark Goodson, Bill Chapman production. This program was edited for broadcast.